Welcome to another video of cleaning Fred and making things nice and shiny. You are sitting in my car right next as I slowly wipe the dashboard on my car. It gets quite dusty with all the ash coming from fires in California. So today my typical vinegar and water solution on the dashboard like that and wipe the area. Nice and clean. Reaching under the windshield in the vents, wiping everything nice and clean, spraying in different areas of the car, including the driver's seat, like that, the steering wheel, the gauge, wiping all the dust, impurities, ash, and other things that could have landed inside of my car as I keep the windows open. To clean the steering wheel, but as I touch it every day, really get in every single aspect of the steering wheel, including all the handles and gauges. That I don't know what they serve. Really getting around them, scrubbing it nice and clean. The steering wheel is whole, so you see some damage to it, but still cleaning it is important. I actually ordered a steering wheel cover that I hope will help me to maintain the surfaces better. And here I'm just getting into the vents on the side of the car. Each vent is really needing proper cleaning. Underneath the steering wheel and right in between the main dashboard and the steering wheel, where the dust accumulates and often you don't really get there to clean. A little bit more spraying. And now the main monitor. used to be a fancy function when my car was first built, but now they're much better monitors. Now on to the compartment right next to the driver's seat. I tend to put a lot of stuff in there, so it's good to really clean it out properly. I find some nuts in there, and that is because I was just recently on a road trip. There's some remnants of a gum that probably won't come off, but it's okay. Really getting in the cup holders, trying to get out all the particles, all the dust and flowers that keep falling into my car when I open the roof, and I tend to park under a tree that loses flowers right now, so it's important to really get in there, clean it out, because this stuff kills. And then again, all the dust that needs to be cleaned. Now I'm using some paper towels. These are not very good, but create nice sounds. I'm getting into all the areas, including this little compartment. Scrubbing it. Getting in the corners. There we go. That's much better. So cleaning the cover portion. Like that. And making sure that everything is clean. And then switching to the main compartment where I store a lot of things. Getting my Bluetooth out and spraying more into this compartment as it accumulates a lot of dust. Taking a piece of paper towel with me. This was one of the few times that I used paper towels. Just because often towels leave fuzzies all over, and paper tends to be better. Although I don't use paper towels almost at all. Cleaning the glassy surfaces that are still glass-like, reflective. Now getting under the emergency brake handle, and then finally into the compartment itself. Making all the remnants of the vinegar solution. Finishing up with just the cloth, making sure that everything is good, and now I'm reaching out from a different side is cleaning the remaining part of the dashboard that is still not clean. Again, getting under the dash, the windshield, onto the dashboard, cleaning out the vents, both sides, very thoroughly, like that, really getting into those vents and wiping off all the liquid that left a little bit of a spot here and there, and doing some detail cleaning of the vents themselves, making sure no dust is left behind. Just the side handle on the door, spraying it a little bit of vinegar solution, getting into all these areas, like that, really scrubbing in, holding the door tight so that it doesn't close on me. Very important part, and then really getting into these surfaces where dust and dirt gets trapped, like that, and then the side panel as well that tends to accumulate a lot of dust. Now the tire rims. I haven't done my tire rims in a while. Really getting into the surfaces, removing this black dust, like that, making sure that the rims are nice and clean. Spraying more liquid. Getting into all three sides of each of the triangle. Each corner as well, although some corners won't be cleaned too well because this is more of a leftover dust that kind of got embedded into the tire rims, so you won't see much progress here, but still a good attempt is a good attempt. These are the rear tires, so they don't accumulate as much dust. Nice, that's good. Looks much, much better. Okay, on to the front tires, front rims, that definitely much more, much dirtier. Ideally, you would wash that first with water, but I don't really have that possibility to do that, so I need to use my solution to clean the rims out. Again, going over every single triangle, side of the triangle, with a piece of paper towel. Again, typically I would use towels, but these are way too dirty to really get into the paper, the regular towels, otherwise they just won't get clean over. And you can see already what the difference it's made cleaning those tire ends. And a little bit more paper towel like that. And as vinegar solution dries out, I need to replenish it. Replenish it well. And then get rid of that dust and dirt, and brake dust tended to always accumulate on my tire ends for some reason. And it's just the upkeep. I don't really wash my car too often, just because it's, I find this an expense to be useless at times. So I like to just keep it clean inside and do it myself. Then do it professionally. Okay, and just two more triangles left right here on this tire end. Again, doing it very thoroughly in the corners so that no dust is left. And I have to change paper towels here and there and respray it again, just because it keeps washing the dirt from the inside of the tire onto the rims. And I know it's somewhat inevitable, but I want them to look nice. There we go, and one more triangle left. I also try to get into the bolts, because they do tend to catch a bit of dirt and dust, but it's not as visible, it's not as significant. Really getting into every corner, every single side of the triangle. Like that. Making it nice and clean. You see how much dust and dirt is on the paper towel? Incredible, right? Nice. I feel much better and just doing some final touches on the whole Honda, the little middle circle. There we go. Now that looks much, much better. Very good. And then on my second front tire is just as dirty as you can see. And again, I'm taking a paper towel here and starting from the top. It is pretty hot outside right now, so the liquid gets evaporated pretty quickly, so I have to do it over and over again. Again, cleaning the area nice and thorough like that. Very good. And all three sides of the triangle. Really getting into all the corners, really getting into all the indentation and sides of the tire end. Just like that, cleaning it very thoroughly. all sides, all corners, just like that, as liquid evaporates, and just spray more and make sure that all the dirt is cleaned off the tire rim of this particular triangle like that, and all around the valve where you use which you use to inflate or deflate the tire. All half done. So the next thing is this area right here. Really getting into this. Cleaning also the front area right here. Really scrubbing it. Scrubbing it back and forth, back and forth like that. And respraying it again. Making sure that no dirt is left behind. Alright, and finishing off just the areas into the triangle on both sides, all three sides, grabbing more paper towels and really getting into this. Like that. All three corners. And then last triangle. Making sure again that everything is clean. I sprayed a little bit, some of that on the rotors, and they were not too thrilled about it, but they would stand even the more abuse with breaking every day. So I don't feel bad for them. Nice, it looks perfect. Almost perfect, as perfect as could.